friends. I'm Miss Stephanie. I teach at the 11 o'clock service for Rockets and Stars. This is my dog, Wrigley. Can you say hello, Wrigley? We're so happy to get to be coming into your home this weekend to help with this lesson, even if we can't quite meet in person. But I hope you guys are all staying healthy and safe and having lots of fun with your families. So today is May 17th, and we're still learning about a man named Joseph, and that name should sound very familiar to you guys at this point. So, on our Bible adventure, Joseph had some big troubles with his brother when he was young. Do you have brothers or even sisters? And maybe you go on adventures or get in trouble, or you know how siblings can be. He probably wondered the same question, though, that Emily is asking Shine this month. Why did God make me? Today, Mr. Music will help us discover the answer to that. But before we see what Mr. Music has to say, we'll have a little music of our own going on. So it's time to worship. So stand up, grab your family, and let's worship together. Don't forget to help your family with the big motions to the songs, because I know that you know them, guys. All right, let's do this.
Okay, now we're going to do the Fruit of the Spirit song. You guys ready for that one? Don't forget to count on all the fruits of the Spirit. Remember, it goes like this. God's fruit is love, joy, peace, patience, kindness, goodness, faithfulness, gentleness, and self-control. You got that? Here we go. God's fruit is love, joy, peace, patience, kindness, goodness, faithfulness, gentleness, and self-control. Love, joy, peace, patience, kindness, goodness, faithfulness, gentleness, and self-control. Oh, don't forget your wolf ears. Oh! The fruit of the Spirit's not a banana. The fruit of the Spirit's not an apple. If you want to be a banapple, you might as well hear it. You can't be a fruit of the Spirit. God's fruit is love, joy, peace, patience, kindness, goodness, faithfulness, gentleness, and self-control. Love, joy, peace, patience, kindness, goodness, faithfulness, gentleness, and self-control. Oh, the fruit of the Spirit's not a kiwi. The fruit of the Spirit's not a watermelon. If you want to be a ketermelon, you might as well hear it. You can't be a fruit of the Spirit. God's fruit is love, joy, peace, patience, kindness, goodness, faithfulness, gentleness, and self-control. Love, joy, peace, patience, kindness, goodness, faithfulness, gentleness, and self-control. Oh, now it's your turn. You guys pick a fruit, and then pick a second fruit, and then you get to smash them together. The fruit of the Spirit's not a... Pick your fruit. The fruit of the Spirit's not a... What's your second fruit? Now you get to smash them together. If you want to be a... You might as well hear it. You can't be a fruit of the Spirit. God's fruit is love, joy, peace, patience, kindness, goodness, faithfulness, gentleness, and self-control. Love, joy, peace, patience, kindness, goodness, faithfulness, gentleness, and self-control. Two more. My God is so big, so strong, and so mighty, there's nothing my God cannot do. My God is so big, so strong, and so mighty, there's nothing my God cannot do. The mountains are His, the rivers are His, the stars are His handiwork too. My God is so big, so strong, and so mighty, there's nothing my God cannot do. My God is so big, so strong, and so mighty, there's nothing my God cannot do. My God is so big, so strong, and so mighty, there's nothing my God cannot do. He made the trees, He made the seas, He made the elephants too. My God is so big, so strong, and so mighty, there's nothing my God cannot do. For you. our last song is Jesus Loves Me.
Oh, Jesus loves me, this I know, for the Bible tells me so. Little ones to him belong, they are weak, but he is strong.
Let me see your muscles.
Oh, yes, Jesus loves me. Yes, Jesus loves me. Yes, Jesus loves me. The Bible tells me so.
Hope to see you guys soon. Have a great Sunday and a great week. We'll see you next week. Bye.
On your mark, get set, go on a Bible adventure. So many ways that I will grow on my Bible adventure. I'm gonna learn my memory verse. I'm gonna pray and talk to God. I'm gonna sing new songs to God and keep singing the songs all week long. Oh, do 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 do. Get set, go on a Bible adventure. Church is fun place, we can go on a Bible adventure.
Oh, hi friends. I was just thinking about my star friend, Shine.
Way! Hiya, Emily! Hiya, friends!
Shine! I'm so glad you're here!
Me too! And I have a question for you. Why did God make me?
Let's go on a Bible adventure to find out! Friends, shake your hands high in the sky if you'll go with me! Woohoo! Friends, pretend to put on your adventure bags.
I have some picture passes that will help you.
Friends, you and I will be picture pass guessers together.
Here's your first clue. It helps you count the days.
Friends, which picture pass is it? Great job, friends. It's the calendar. Catch it in your adventure bags.
Here's your next clue. You can find it outside. It has leaves on it.
Friends, which one is it? I think you're right. It's the tree.
Friends, catch the tree in your adventure bags. Now for your last clue. It's something you carry with you when you have somewhere to go and something to do.
Friends, what do you think it is? I think you've got it. It's the backpack.
Catch it in your adventure bags.
Friends, count with me. One, two, three. Yep, they're all here. Let's zip our adventure bags together. Now it's time to fly.
Whoa.
Shine, how will we find the answer to the question, why did God make me?
When we're looking for answers, the Bible is the best place to start.
The Bible is God's book for you. You can trust. It's right and true.
The dreamer. That story's from the book of Genesis in the Bible.
Let's see how it will help us.
Jacob had 12 sons. But he loved his son Joseph the most. He gave Joseph a special brightly colored coat. Joseph's brothers were jealous of him. They hated him. Joseph also had special dreams. "In my dream, we were tying up bundles of wheat," he said, "and your bundles bowed down to mine." Joseph's brothers hated him even more. Joseph had another dream. "The sun, the moon, and 11 stars bowed down before me." His father and brothers grumbled. "Are you saying you will rule over us?" One day, Joseph's brothers were in the fields watching their sheep. They saw him coming to see them. They planned to kill him and put an end to all his dreams. "It would be wrong to kill our brother," said Reuben. "Let's throw him in this empty well." So they tore off Joseph's special coat and threw him into the well. Ishmaelite traders came by on their way to Egypt. "Let's sell Joseph as a slave to the Ishmaelites," suggested Judah. So the brothers sold Joseph for 20 pieces of silver. The brothers dipped Joseph's coat in goat's blood and showed it to Jacob. "My son is dead," he wept. Meanwhile, Joseph was taken to Egypt, but God was with Joseph. In Egypt, the Ishmaelites sold Joseph to Potiphar, one of Pharaoh's captains. God blessed Joseph and made him successful. Potiphar put Joseph in charge of his whole household.
Wow, Joseph had some strange dreams. And some bad things happened to him, too.
But that wasn't the end of Joseph's story. His dreams came true. God had good plans for Joseph.
He did?
Yeah, God made Joseph a great leader. God's plans for us are always good.
Hey, that's great. But I still don't know the answer to the question. Why did God make me?
Maybe Guy, the Bible guy, can help.
That's a great idea. I'm gonna go ask him. See you, Shine.
See you, Emily.
Come on.
Come in!
Hi, Guy.
Hi, Emily. Hi, friends.
I was hoping you could help me answer a question. Why did God make me?
God has good plans for me.
Hey, that's what Shine said. But I don't know what God's plan even means.
God's plans are the good things he wants you to do. And his plans for everyone who loves and follows Jesus are always good.
I do that, Guy. I really try to love and follow Jesus every day.
That's great. You can be sure that God has good plans for all your days.
All your days? I have a picture pass about that. Friends, which picture pass helps you count the days? Way to go, friends! It's the calendar. The calendar shows us every day that's coming.
That's right. And God has a plan for every day. We don't know what will happen, but God knows, and his plans for us are so good.
Bye, Guy.
Bye, Emily. Bye, friends.
Come on.
La 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 la, la la la, do 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 do. Oh, hi, Xenia. Hey, you have your backpack. That can only mean one thing.
Oh, yeah? What's that?
You have somewhere to go and something to do.
You're right about that.
Well, you don't seem very happy about it.
I'm not. I can't stay with my mommy and daddy right now, so I have to go stay with my Aunt Petunia.
That doesn't sound so bad.
But I've never stayed with my Aunt Petunia. What if she's mean to me? And who will I play with? Blinky, I'm scared.
You don't have to be afraid, Xenia. God has super-dee-duper good plans for us.
But this doesn't seem good at all.
God's plans are always good. even when things don't seem very good.
I don't know about that.
Xenia, remember when you were afraid of the dark and you trusted God?
I do remember. After that, I never needed a nightlight again.
That's because you knew God was with you then, and He's with you now.
And He has good plans for me. Blinky, will you pray for me so I never forget that ever again?
You bet I will. Dear God, please help Xenia and all of us remember that your plans for us are good, no matter what. In Jesus' name, amen.
Okay, well, I'm off to do the good things God has planned for me.
I'll miss you, Xenia, but I'll see you when you get back. And I know God is with you.
Thanks, Blinky. Friends forever?
Friends forever. High five.
Yeah.
Yeah. See you soon.
Okay, bye.
Hey, friends. I'm so glad Guy figured out the answer to the question, why did God make me? Friends, say the answer with me. God has good plans for me. The calendar shows us that God has good plans for us every day. I want to do the good things God has planned for me because His plans are good. It's like our Bible verse says, Jeremiah 29:11. I know the plans I have for you, says the Lord. They are plans for good. So good, so good. Do you hear that? You know what that means. Mr. Music must have a song for us. Come on, let's go.
Hi, Emily. Hi, friends.
Hi, Mr. Music. Do you know the answer to the question, why did God make me?
God has good plans for me.
Yeah, that's right.
God has a plan for everything He made. That includes all of us.
God made you and me and flowers and trees. Wait, I have a picture pass about that. Friends, which picture pass can you find outside? It has leaves on it. That's right, friends. It's the tree. Mr. Music, what plans does God have for a tree?
What good things did God make trees to do?
Well, trees give us shade from the sun, and they make nuts and fruit for the animals to eat.
That's right, and for us too. I love eating the fruit that grows on trees, like apples and oranges.
Oh, and bananas and peaches. Oh, I'm so glad that God has plans for trees.
And God has a plan for you too, and His plans are always good.
Where is Shine? Friends, do you hear that star? Shine, there you are! We've had so much fun on our Bible adventure!
Did you find the answer to the question, why did God make me?
Yup, yup, yuppers! Friends, say it with me. God has good plans for me!
That's right. And what Bible verse did Guy teach you?
Friends, let's say it for Shine. Jeremiah 29:11. I know the plans I have for you, says the Lord. They are plans for good. So good, so good.
God God's plans are good. What did you find out about the picture passes?
The calendar lets me know that God has good things for me to do every day.
Every day is part of God's good plan.
And the tree reminds me that God has a plan for everything he made. Even the trees. Even me.
And God's plans are always good.
Oh, but I still don't know about the backpack.
The backpack is something you carry with you when you have somewhere to go and something to do.
Shine! That's it! God has good plans for me. When he leads me somewhere new, he has good things for me to do.
Wee! Now let's pray for our friends so they will know God has good plans for them too.
Okay. Friends, bow your heads and close your eyes. We're going to talk to God together. Dear God, thank you for planning good things for us to do. Help us to love and follow you. In Jesus' name, amen. Pandas and popsicles, it's time to go. We'll see you next time.
For another Bible adventure.
Bye-bye, friends.
Guys, I'm so glad Mr. Music helped us answer the question, why did God make us? And I'm glad I got to share it with you. I also want to share with you how you can learn more about today's lesson. Do your map book. You guys all know your map book, and I know a lot of you guys love that map book, and you know why. P-R-I-Z-E. Where do you get a map book now, since I can't just hand one to you when you're leaving the class? Just print it out at home. Ask your parents if they can download it from New Life's website under the KidZone section. And remember to hold on to all the map books that you've been working hard on, guys. So when you finish them, bring them back into KidZone when we get to see each other again, and I'll make sure that you get a great prize. I can't wait to see you guys again. Stay happy and stay safe and healthy. Bye, guys.